we have with us Joseph Puckett today from Craig Wiggins Coaching and Consulting. He has founded, or co-founded, I should say, CWC with Craig Wiggins. They've been working together for years, and he has helped Craig build his book of business to over like $40 million in revenue, which is insane. Obviously, he has a ton of information on how to efficiently run a business, just all aspects of running an insurance agency. And today we're going to be talking about the importance of long-term ROI focus when it comes to leads, plus re-quoting, win-backs, and cross-selling, which are all extremely important for quoting and lead follow-up. So I'm going to hand it over to Joseph to kick us off. And again, guys, please try and keep it to the Q&A so we can keep a little organization going on here.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Kelsey. And thank you to all of you watching live or the recording. I'm so excited to be with you today. And I want to thank my friends over at Quote Wizard. You know, Kelsey, their whole team is fantastic. We were just talking about our Vegas event that we have coming up in August. They're always such a big part of CWC events and might be something that you might want to consider. But I want to thank you for your partnership. Y'all do amazing work. Craig has bought, you know, leads from Quote Wizard, I don't know how long, like going back years and years and years. Y'all have always been great for our agency, but also wonderful to work with the 1,500 agencies in CWC's program. So I just appreciate y'all. She already gave a nice little introduction on me, but I want to show my headshot. Y'all, I got this headshot just for this purpose. I'm just kidding. But the quick story, you know, I started my own little Allstate agency back in 2009. I was 25 years old, borrowed every penny of money that I had put in the bank to prove that I had 50 grand in the bank to own my own little agency. And within 6 months was basically out of money, didn't know what the heck I was doing. Thankfully, I met Craig Wiggins. Back then, he was about 10 million or so in premium. And I knew I could go much further working with him. I wasn't ready to be an agency owner at that age without capital. So I jumped onto Craig's bandwagon. I grabbed onto his coattails and never let go. Joined his team in 2011 officially, and we grew to over $40 million in premium, over $40 million over the past 11, 12 years or so. And now we work with over 1,500 agencies in our program, teaching them how we did that, right? So I'm excited to share a lot with y'all today. This call, we're going to keep it to an hour, might slightly go over. I've got a lot of things that I want to go over with y'all, but plus I want to have some time for Q&A if there are any. So let's go ahead and dive in. But before we jump straight into this webinar, I know some of y'all might have to jump off, grab a call, do something else. I wanted to make sure that you didn't miss this special offer because you're giving your time today. I want to give something to you. I hope you're going to learn a lot and take a lot of notes. But y'all, I would also love, if you're not already involved with Craig Wiggins Coaching, that you check us out. Check out CraigWigginsCoaching.com. Learn more about our on-demand program. We have over, 1,200 videos on our platform. We do live training every single week, including role play. We have over 100 documents and processes on our platform, everything from sales scripts, service scripts, marketing plans and guides, agency handbooks, example compensation plans, operations, policy review checklists. I could go on. There's over 100 documents and processes on our platform. Oh, and our scripts, you're going to love. You and your team would love the CWC scripts. That's just kind of a brief list of some of the scripts that we have on the platform. Long story short, we'd love to help you. If you use QW2022 as a little promo code, you can try us out for $20. $20 for the first month. It is $177 a month thereafter for unlimited access, unlimited number of users, unlimited everything, all the live training, the documents, the online platform, all for less than $6 a day for your entire team. I'd love for y'all to take us out. If you have questions, shoot me an email, joseph@craigwigginscoaching.com. There's my 90-second pitch. Let's jump into learning. So we have many courses on how to work internet and live transfer leads on Craig Wiggins Coaching's platform. A couple main tips that I just want to go over before we jump into like the ROI and other things. I'm going to spend a lot more time today talking about other lead types like requotes, win backs, cross sales. Going to go through all that today. But a couple of things that you have to be training your staff. And I mentioned training your staff. I'll talk more about that in just a few minutes, just how important that is. We got to assume that every lead is a buyer. Y'all, are you going to have to dig through some dirt to find the gold? Yes. Quote Wizard's an amazing, amazing vendor, but there's sometimes not so best leads come through the filters. Sure. Sometimes people lie. I always jokingly say that prospects and customers, the two biggest lies they ever tell to their insurance agent are, my record's clean. And then we run the reports like, what about these four tickets? Oh yeah. The next biggest lie is, I need to speak with my spouse. No, they don't. But again, we don't have time to talk about all that stuff. Another biggest lie is they're online and they just click, the wrong answers, whatever. So we can't go into every call thinking, oh, this is going to be another junkie lead. No, we need to pick up that phone, call that person, expecting them to buy. Go into it with a positive mindset, a positive attitude, and you watch your staff have way more success. Way more success as they're working their leads. We also cannot assume that a purchased lead is just going to be a price-sensitive direct shopper who will only buy because we're less in rate. Many of you on this call are captive. Some might be independent watching this. You might have multiple options. But y'all, you likely represent a carrier or carriers that aren't the low-cost provider in your area, right? Especially if you're on the captive side. We can't sell them what we can't control. Literally, the one thing we can't control is the rates. Your carriers set the rates. What we can control is the advice that we give. And how do we do that? The most important part of the CWC sales process, y'all, is called lead with liability. We lead with liability coverage. Now, in the last webinar I did with Quote Wizard, was that in January? I can't remember. A couple months ago, I did a webinar for Quote Wizard friends. It's probably on their blog or on their YouTube or whatever. I taught how to do that. We're not going to revisit that now. Today is about other things. But we lead with liability. We lead with liability. We sell coverage in our advice, not just the lowest price. And watch your numbers go through the roof. Watch your close rate go through the roof. Watch your production just blast off. Watch your team members be happier because they're closing more deals, right? It's a win-win-win when we sell what we can control. And we focus on what we can control, coverage, not the lowest price. Very important. We teach your team members via the CWC scripts and our training videos how to start the conversation to get them to agree to the quotes, how to keep them on the phone while quoting them. That is super important. You might be spending thousands of dollars a month on leads and marketing. We can't allow our staff just to get somebody on the phone, get them interested in quotes, and just gather some basic information and say, okay, I'll call you back later. There are a few things on earth that I hate. Very few things on earth that I hate. I hate onions. I'm sorry. If y'all make me something with onions, I'm not going to eat it. I'm going to smile and like a sweet boy from Alabama say, thank you. That's wonderful. And then I'm going to throw it away. The next thing that I hate is wasted time. Wasted time, right? You know what wastes more time than anything? Phone tag, right? We get somebody that's interested. We gather some basic info. We're like, all right, let's play some phone tag for a few weeks. I can't stand it. Keep them on the phone. Go through the process. Lead with liability. Bundle, which we're going to talk about today, bundling. Auto, property, umbrella, quoted every time. Assume the close. Don't ask what they think. How does that sound? Let me email this to you. No, assume the close and ask for the payment info, right? The whole process. Get it all in one call, right? That's what we teach on the platform. But guess what? You're going to get more no's than yeses. You're going to get more no's than yeses. So having a follow-up plan on unsold leads is super important. Ladies and gentlemen, what pays? Persistence. Persistence pays is a phrase that we use all the time here at CWC because it's so true. Let's talk about the cost of leads, return on investment, and focusing on the short term and long term just for a few minutes. Y'all, you're buying premium. Right. Whether you're buying an agency to merge into your existing book or have a second location, you're paying staff to work leads and everything. Everything that you do is you're basically buying premium. So a lot of agents expect an immediate positive ROI. What I want y'all to think about, the average lifespan of a customer on your books in a captive world is around seven years. So if you think about the immediate new business commission, you might have an enhanced commissions plan, depending on who you're selling for, what carriers or whatever. You might have bonus opportunity annually or other things. Future renewals, and guess what? Those future renewals increasing because rate increases, right? And then it snowballs and snowballs and snowballs. So over the next 7 years, how much money are you going to make on that household, the average household? You've got to do that math. You know your comp plan, enhanced commission structure, if there are any bonuses, factoring in 10% or so increases over the next 7 years, because that's about average, right? In fact, that's a low year. I know everybody right now is having a challenge with rising rates, and it's actually a good thing at the agency level. It's a great thing, right? More revenue for leads, marketing, staff, et cetera. But long story short, don't go into any lead program, whether it's internet leads or life transfers from our friends at Quote Wizard, whether it's direct mail from our friends at marketingmail.com, Dart Direct Mail, RealComp, you know, things that you're doing inside of the community. That is an investment where you're buying premium, and I wouldn't expect to make money on it in the first month. If you can make money within 1 to 2 renewals, and then everything else is pure profit, that's amazing. That's amazing. It's like buying a book of business. Y'all, if you were to buy a book of business for 2.5 to 3.5 times revenue and take 10 years to pay it off, you'd do it. Because if it made sense, if it was a good, clean, quality book that you like, it cash flows, it's doing it, right? But you're taking 10 years for it to pay for itself, right? Via the loan payments and stuff, versus 6 to maybe 18 months for a lead to pay for itself. That's amazing. So that's just what I want y'all to think about. Having an immediate focus, I know, is important, especially if you're a smaller agency, you don't have a ton of renewals yet. You're like, Joseph, I'm not made of gold, and I've already put in a lot of personal capital, maybe even personal debt, maybe even cash in my 401k. I don't want y'all to go into personal debt to buy leads. We're going to teach you and your staff how to work requotes, win backs, cross sales, and do other things today. And we have many more trainings on our platform on how to generate leads from referral partners and more. I could go on, but we only have an hour. Just understand, y'all, it's an investment in your business. And working with Quote Wizard is an amazing opportunity for you to scale much quicker. But no, you're not going to, you know, have a positive ROI typically in the first month on any lead source. You and your staff will close more leads in months 2 through 6 than you do the first month if properly worked and followed up on. Well, months 7 through 24, you'll probably close more of those leads that you bought in month 1 than you did the first 6 months, right? It's all about the follow-up plan and persistence. And think about this, y'all. How many contact attempts does it typically take to have just the initial conversation? Let's say you bought 10 internet leads from Quote Wizard, and you know, you're looking at 8 to 10 calls just for the initial conversation. But guess what? A lot of the initial conversation is, well, I don't have time right now, or I'm not interested, whatever. So then we're having more contact attempts to have the second real conversation, right? But then guess what? Even if your staff leave the liability, assume the bundle, assume the close, work to overcome objections, more sales will happen after 2 or 3 conversations. That's even more. So a total of having around 20 or more actions per sold deal, super common. So what I can tell you is, if you're only going to call a lead 3 or 4 times, stop wasting your money. Like, literally stop wasting your money. Your team needs to know this too. They need to understand that everything that they do is planting a seed. Every email, every voicemail that they leave, every compliantly sent text message that they send, every handwritten card that they send to a really good prospect that they really want to get on the phone, those are planted seeds. Guess what, y'all? Most of those seeds will die. Most of those seeds will never go into anything else. More voicemails go unreturned than not. Same with email, same with text. But the ones that return, the ones that we can nourish and turn into sale, they turn into beautiful crops. All right. But your staff need to understand that. You need to understand that. Here is an example timeline that I put together for y'all on how to work various lead types. So we have like internet leads here in the middle. We're going to work internet leads way harder than we would a cross sell or a requote. Right? Brand new leads that you're spending, you know, very good money on. We're going to hit them multiple times the first day, every day, the first week. And notice calls and emails. And if you can send texts, being compliant with texting, texts, I would throw in as well. Weeks 2 through 6, couple emails, couple calls. Stay on them for those first 6 to 8-ish weeks. Then what I would like for y'all to do is back off for a little. Then guess what? Ramp it back up again. Old leads are gold leads. Because guess what? These first few days, first few weeks, you're not the only one trying to reach out to them. Your staff is not the only one trying to reach out to them. They're getting calls, emails, texts from three or four different agencies, right? So there's a lot of noise there. But most other agents are so lazy. Well, I don't use the word lazy. Most other agencies are too busy working the newer, fresher leads, they're forgetting about leads they got 4 weeks ago, 6 weeks ago, 6 months ago. You swoop back in and you have basically no competition. I literally know an agency owner, y'all. I'm not going to say who or where or what carrier. He buys as many leads as he can from as many vendors as he can. And he's got good deals because he's a big volume player. Swear to God, y'all, he doesn't touch them for 5 months. He doesn't. That's his strategy. That's his strategy. He buys as much as he can at a high volume, low price. They sit in his database for 5 months. Then they start working him. His contact and close rate's insane. His thought process behind that is I'm not competing with four or five other agencies. We're the only ones working it then. I'm not telling y'all to do that. You're like, Joseph, I need sales today. Great. But understand that as you recycle leads over and over and over again or ramp them back up, you're going to have more success and longer term return on investment. All right. Now, today, we're going to talk more about like cold calls, requotes, and cross sales. See, last time I spent more time on internet leads in our sales process. Today is going to be about these other lead types. So I hope that you're excited to learn how to work some free stuff too, right? Some of the things that you already have in your database. Before I dive into that though, I want to talk for just a moment about our minimum expectations for our team members at Craig Wiggins Agencies. This is an example of one of the over 100 documents and processes that we have on our platform. We call this the pyramid of minimum expectations. This isn't our team members' goals. So you should have different numbers for your staff. What is their bare minimum required to keep their job? Is it 15 policies a month? Is it 15,000 in premium? Is it more? Is it less? Don't tell me, Joseph, my minimum expectation for my staff is 40 policies a month. I'm like, all right, cool. I like that's two items a day, two policies a day. How many people we got doing that now? Well, none, not really none. Well, then that's not your minimum expectation. If they're allowed to stay there, what is it? Is it 20 policies, 15,000 premium, whatever it is? This is the minimum expectations. That's one number. Then we need to have their goal. Their goal should be a higher number. So for our team members, the goal is to get them to 50, 60 plus policies a month minimum. Like, no, their minimum is 40, two a day. Their goal is 50 to 60, and that's where they start making really, really good commissions. Opportunities, the third number, 100 plus policies a month, 100 plus policies. Y'all, we have coached and had on our team over a dozen Century Club agents. That's what we call them. If they write over 100 items a month, 100 policies a month. We've sent dozens and dozens more CWC Century Club awards to staff all across the country who use our training. It's beautiful, right? It's amazing. 100 policies in a month. It's five a day. That's one to two households a day. If we're bundling auto, property, umbrella, right? If we're doing toys, motorcycles, boats, ATVs, life insurance, one or two households a day is 100 policies a month. What we got to do is get our staff thinking bigger. So anyways, minimum expectations, two policies a day, that's 40 a month, or 10 quotes in a day, that's four or five households, auto, property, umbrella, three to five times, right? Or 80 calls a day, that's 10 calls an hour, one call every 6 minutes. 86% of all phone calls are voicemails. Y'all, if my staff can't make 10 phone calls an hour, nor generate four or five households quoted a day to get the 10 quotes, nor write two items, if they just won't even put forth the activity, they don't work with us. See, your staff can't control rates, guidelines. They really can't control your marketing, right? The sources that you're providing. Now, we teach them how they can generate their own leads from customer referrals, referral partnerships, et cetera. But long story short, they can't control any of that stuff. What they can control, though, is their activity. And I think 10 calls an hour is a good bare minimum expectation. So ask yourself, what is your minimums? What are your minimums? What do you accept at your agency? Maybe we need to start raising that bar of what's acceptable. All right. So I hope that helps you when it comes to setting expectations for your current team. But y'all, this is what we go over this with recruits. You know, in the CWC program, we have all of our hiring process and documents, including a very thorough interview guide where we break down how to do the interview. We actually go over this with them in the interview. You know, we're making it crystal clear what our expectations are. See, y'all, expectations without accountability is just blank air in the universe. or just white and black letters on a screen or a piece of paper. Well, there must be accountability to go along with those expectations. All right. And this really has a great deal to do with your culture and your agency. See, we're able to operate extremely lean with much fewer staff. Why? Because we get more from our staff. They do more. And guess what? They make more. You know, we've transformed their lives, you know, so your expectations, how you hold your team accountable, all this stuff is super important. You know, what's really important is training your team, right? Training your team how to work these internet leads and live transfers that you're getting from Quote Wizard, how to work what I'm going to show you all a little bit more about today, requotes, win backs, cross sells, what to say when they have certain objections, how to do the most important parts of the sales process, lead with liability, building rapport, and assumptive close, right? Training, role playing, weekly team meetings, weekly individual coaching, at least once a week with each person where you're going over through a recorded call or two. Not just dissecting the call and trying to figure out where they screwed up, right? I don't want them to always feel like their meetings with you are getting called to the principal's office. No. Find one or two things to praise. Hopefully there's something in there that we can praise, right? And then one, maybe two things max to work on. Maybe they need to be more assumptive and assertive at the beginning of the call to get more quotes. Maybe they're getting enough quotes, but they're only quoting monoline customers, just the auto or just the property, and they're not even asking to quote the other lines. We can work on that. We must. I'm going to talk more about that in a minute. Maybe they're quoting it all pretty good, but they can't close for nothing. They're saying things at the end like, how does that sound? What do you think? Can I email these to you? Y'all, that's not how we close deals, right? So anyways, you find those one or two most important things they need to work on, and that's all you work on. One or two things to praise, one at most two things to work on. They're in and out in 15, 20 minutes. But your time invested in your staff's development, y'all, will dramatically increase your success and theirs, their success and yours, all right? Now, for those of you with CWC training, daily, 15 to 30 minutes first thing every day as you're going through the 1,200 training videos on the platform that are all neatly, cleanly organized. I highly recommend, you know, daily training with CWC, weekly team meetings, weekly at a minimum, once a week, each week with one team member during recorded calls. Make sure that we're also having recognition and praise publicly. I think that's really important. Maybe you've been working with a team member on how to overcome a certain objection and you hear them do it. You listen to that recorded call, you're like, oh my God, they did it. They did it. We've been working on this for weeks. Make a big deal about it, right? Somebody has their biggest day ever. The first day they ever wrote 10 or more policies in a day. They have their first double digit day, DDD, double digit day, right? Make a big deal about it. Now, that's public. Constant reinforcement in private. Right? Constant reinforcement, meaning we're finding things that they're not saying what they should be saying or doing what they should be doing. That needs to be constant, y'all. We can't just wait. We can't just brush it under the rug. It's not going to get better, right? We need to address it. We need to address it right away. And it's all about investing in your team, mainly time. See, y'all, time is your most valuable asset. It can either be invested or wasted, right? We don't want to waste your time. We want to invest your time. I promise you right now, you might be saying, Joseph, I'm so busy. I don't have time to train my team. I don't have time to go through those things. We can help with that, right? We can help, but I can promise you, you can make time for what's important, and giving your team members your time is the most important investment you can ever make in them. All right. So I just really want to challenge y'all to invest, not just, you know, money into training, which is helpful, right, to help duplicate what you're trying to accomplish, but invest your time in them. I promise the returns will be worth every minute. I promise. Now, scripts. I'm going to spend just a couple minutes to go through some of CWC scripts, Craig Wiggins coaching scripts. We have dozens and dozens of them on the platform. I hit this pretty hard. I think it was January when I did my last Quote Wizard webinar, but I've got my internet lead script. We don't have time to go through all this stuff here today, but if you want to take a screenshot or something, happy for you to see. Now, this is just the opening line about being assumptive and assertive to start the call. We have some of the most common objections. I don't have time right now. What you talking about, Willis? I didn't request no quotes, or I'm happy now. I've changed my mind. I'm no longer shopping for insurance. I'm happy. I didn't know 17 people going to be calling me, right? So we have kind of some common objections to answer. We have many videos on every single lead source, internet leads. Let's see here. Live transfers. I love Quote Wizard live transfers. I know that they're an investment, but why I love live transfers over internet leads, honestly, is because we're at least talking to somebody. It might cost four or five times the cost of an internet lead, but you might have to buy 10 internet leads to quote one or two, or just buy one or two live transfers and we're at least talking to somebody, right? So that's why we love live transfer scripts, but there's certain things that we need to say at the beginning to make sure that they qualify, that they should have got through the filters, and that they're a good prospect and that we can help and we can proceed. Or if we can't help, let them go as quickly as possible and or exit them, right, for when we can. And again, common objections. Opening objections. These are kind of the most common objections that we have. Just some examples here. I don't have time. My policy's just renewed. How'd you get my info? Why are you calling me, right? I only want one quote. This is just a snippet of some of our scripts here on the platform. Then we have training videos on every single one of these. Overcoming objections at the end of the call. In fact, today, in an hour and a half for CWC members, I'm actually doing a live training for all of our members. We do it every single Wednesday afternoon at the same time, 3 o'clock Eastern, on overcoming objections at the end of the call. Last week, it was overcoming objections at the beginning, but that's live training that we do. But again, y'all, I'm just trying to share as much as I can with you. Take screenshots. You know, feel free to try to figure this stuff out on your own. Use it. I want to give you as many resources as possible. Now, what did I say at the beginning? We can't just quote. Right. Here's another saying that we have, y'all. You and your staff are not paid to quote. You're paid to close. So here is our assumptive close top path. We've quoted their cars. We've quoted their home. I sure hope we've talked to them and quoted an umbrella, especially if they qualify. Now we're at the end of the 30, 40 minute call. It's time to give them the rates and ask for the payment info. Well, here is the structure that we use for assumptive close. No, notice, you know, right here in bold, do not ask, what do you think? How does that sound? How do we compare? What do you mean, how do we compare? Can I email these to you? Y'all, I work with many agencies all across the country. Personally, I work with about 50 agencies in my program individually. And I coach their staff 2 to 3 times a month. Just them. I basically live on Zoom. And, you know, a couple of weeks ago, I had an agency that had been just in my program for a couple of weeks, working with our team members. One of the team members was really, really good. She wasn't closing as much as some of her other peers were. I said, man, send me a call. Let me listen to one of her calls. Y'all, this customer was literally begging her to buy the policy. Like, he said things like, oh, wow, that sounds good. What did he say? Oh, what really got me was when he said, what are the next steps? What are the next steps? Where do we go from here? Promise. She talked herself out of the sale. She kept talking and talking and talking, trying to sell the value and features and benefits and blah, blah, blah. Talked herself out of the sale. The dude was literally begging to buy the policy, and she ends up emailing it to him, right? She closed it the next day, but that deal should have been closed right away because that time could have been invested in that next prospect, right? So we got to seal the deal, get the digits, right? Get the digits by asking for their payment info. Seal the deal. But we spend a lot of time training on assumptive close on our platform. Now, I want to spend some time talking about some free leads. So we talked about the importance of internet leads, live transfers, you know, working with our friends at Quote Wizard. But let's talk about some free leads, you know, because this will help your overall return on investment. For example, requotes and winbacks. The initial quote could have come from a Quote Wizard lead 9 months ago. Well, we're going to keep working that lead until they buy from us or they literally stop breathing. Or third option, if they opt out. Y'all, we have to be compliant. If somebody says, stop calling me, stop emailing me, we have to do that, right? But we have a buy or die philosophy with our mindset. We're going to keep working with a prospect until they buy from us or they literally stop breathing or they opt out. Winbacks. Maybe you wrote that customer, but they left within a year or two, whatever, they go somewhere else. Well, y'all, the grass is not always greener on the other side. We love winbacks. Love, love, love winbacks. So, but it might have come from a purchase lead source. So guess what? You can actually get paid twice on that, not just on renewals and stuff like that, but you get them back Maybe you even have an enhanced commission opportunity with your carrier and you can win them back and get paid again, right? Once that data is in the system, it's still an internet lead or life transfer or a paid lead source, that's fine, but really it starts to become free to work over and over and over. And then the third thing we're gonna talk about today is cross sales, outbound and inbound. Because we only have about 30 more minutes, y'all, I can't go deep into every single topic. I just wanna hit as many key points as I can to help you and really encourage those that are on the fence about joining CWC to get the whole shebang for 20 bucks. Use QW2022 as the promo code at CraigWigginsCoaching.com. Why we love requotes. What I just say, they're basically free. Free leads. They could have been paid at some point in the past, but now they're free. We're going to work them over and over and over. And that will dramatically increase your return on investment for your lead and marketing spend. The grass is not always greener on the other side. You quote them and like, ooh, I don't know. I'm going to stay put. Things change, rates change. Maybe they had a negative claim experience. Maybe they had a negative service experience. Maybe their agent retires and they don't like the new agent, whatever. They will be way more open and receptive. And y'all, this year, there is gonna be a lot of shaking up in the industry, like a lot. Carriers are having to dramatically change rates. Underwriting guidelines are changing. Policies getting non-renewed. That's awesome. Now I know if you're dealing with a lot of that stuff, it's a headache and you're having to deal with a lot of that stuff. But keep in mind, other carriers, other agencies are dealing with the same things, right? And people are being more and more and more receptive to requotes. I did a training last week with an agency that I work with in Texas. I think she's in Texas. And they've been hitting their requotes really, really hard, people that they quoted last year, because they've been behind so many leads. I'm like, well, all right, what about the leads you quoted 6 months ago? What about 12 months ago? All right, we're not really working those. I said, all right, trim your new leads down a bit. Keep them still trickling in. Trim them down just a tad. I want you to hit requotes hard. This girl wrote over 50 items last month just on requotes alone. Didn't work a single new lead. Over 50 policies written just on requotes. Why? Because people are being way more receptive now because they're having rate increases and just things that are going on with their carrier. Why I love requotes is they let us quote them in the past. Now, a serious requote is where we ran reports, you know, insurance scores, loss histories, whatever. If it's just an old lead, that's not really a requote if we never quoted them. Treat it as such. Remember what I said at the beginning, go into every call assuming that you're talking to a buyer, right? But requotes, when I talk about requotes, primarily what I mean is people that we actually ran reports on. Serious requotes is what we call them. People that we actually talk to, they'll be more likely to let us talk to them again, all right? What pays? Persistence. Stay on top of them. That will dramatically increase the return on investment that you have for leads. Now, from your team's perspective, let's just openly talk about fears or concerns that get in their way on requotes, right? The biggest thing, remember what I hate, onions, y'all know that now, and wasted time, things like phone tag, things like analysis paralysis, reading notes, trying to figure out, yeah, my girl Kelsey, you know, my team member Kelsey called this person, you know, a long time ago. Let me see why we didn't get them. Let me read through some of her notes and see why. Was it rates? You know, is it something else? Who cares? Pick up the phone. If there's one thing I could tattoo on my forehead, it would be this. Pick up the phone. Don't just read notes. What we do is we glance in the system. I want to make sure that I'm using the right talk path for a customer or prospect. I would hate to have a list of quotes that we had done at our agency and give that to a team member and say, all right, call these requotes from last, you know, January to June of 2021. Give them a call, reach out, see if we can requote them. And they call and say, hey, it's Joseph Puckett here at so-and-so agency, Craig Wiggins agency. I was just giving you a call because it's been a while since we last looked at insuring that beautiful home. They're like, what are you talking about? I'm a current customer there. Maybe we quoted their home, but they decided not to buy it, right? They were looking at, or maybe we quoted and wrote their home, but it was two different quotes because two different people were involved. I'm a big fan of glancing in the system first. See, do they have any existing policies? If so, we leave with a mini review for cross-sell. Do they have no active policies now, but terminated policies? Well, that's a win back. No active or terminated, that's a requote. And then we can use the right talk path, which I'm gonna show a screenshot of the little script here in just a second. But who cares why we didn't quote them? Were our rates higher last time? Probably, right? They want fresher, newer leads all the time. Let them know that old leads are gold leads. Old leads are gold leads. It can't be like Glengarry, Glen Ross. You ever watched that movie? Right? Where they want the Glengarry leads, those precious leads, right? What does it say? You know, coffee's for closers or whatever. Yeah, you want the Glengarry leads? Close what you already got now. Y'all know what I'm talking about, Alec Baldwin. They want the fresh stuff, the new stuff. Y'all, the old leads are gold leads. They need to understand that. They're going to have tons of success. We love requotes. Love, love, love requotes. What are the keywords that we use? A lot has changed. Guess what? That can basically overcome anything that what it was. Maybe our rates were a bit higher. Maybe it wasn't the right time. Maybe we didn't have a program that they were interested in or something, whatever. A lot has changed. A lot has changed potentially with the level of advice that we're going to give. See, maybe last time when we were quoting them, we quoted on price alone and not giving them good advice, right? Giving them good advice and making the right coverage recommendations, leading with liability covers, bundling the whole package. Y'all, I want to talk to people about saving money. I do. I love when somebody says, you know what, I want to talk about saving some money in my insurance. Oh, good. Me too. We're on the same page. See, it's rare. It is super rare that I don't find where I can save someone literally thousands of dollars, tens of thousands of dollars, even more if they need their insurance. So we're on the same page. We're going to make sure that you have the right coverages at the best rates possible. Absolutely. Okay. A lot has changed. There's no reason to be reading notes. What did I say? 86% of phone calls end up being a voicemail. Probably more than that, right? What a waste of time. If your staff have more than 30 seconds or 60 seconds of glancing at the system, just make sure we use the right talk path before they call. They are dramatically wasting time and it's killing their ability to have more activity. So no analysis paralysis, no reading notes, just as Buddy the Elf says, pick up the phone. Actually, he doesn't say that, but that's just what he does, right? Pick up the phone, dial that phone and follow the script. So here we have, and I know we don't have time to teach all of this stuff. I'm just trying to expose it to all of you. Here we have a screenshot of our requote script, the introduction, where we want to assume the quote. Right? Assume the quote. This is very important. Everything that we do is assumptive and assertive. From assuming the quote, to assuming the quote of the other lines, like the bundle, to assuming the close, to assuming the asking for referrals at the end. We have the ball. The ball's in our court. We're not giving them the ball to have the ball in their court. We're not going to say things and give them an out by saying things like, hey, is this a good time? Is this a good time? Am I interrupting your Netflix time? No. Hey, would you be interested in a quote? We've got great new rates. Do you want that? Someone calls you right now and says, hey, we've got great new rates on our cell phone plans. Can I talk to you? No, I'm good. Right? Assume the quote by asking something like, hey, are you still at 123 Main Street? Not, would you like a quote or is this a good time? Here's some common objections. I don't have time. I'm not interested. Your rates were too high last time. I'm happy where I'm at now. We don't have time to go through all this. But requotes. This is something that y'all must have a process to be constantly working. In addition to your new leads, we need to go back through the old leads and the old quotes that we've done. Let's talk about winbacks for a minute. Winbacks, look at my minions. Winbacks are our favorite free campaign. We absolutely love winbacks. Just like requotes, the grass ain't always greener. Someone left you, likely. Why? To save a little bit of money. That's most of the reason why. Sometimes they might have had a negative experience with you, but that's rare, right? Like a negative claim experience, negative service experience, whatever. It's typically because they saved a little bit of money, right? They saved a little bit of money, they switched. Well, guess what? The grass ain't always greener. Their rates go up, right? So they're way more receptive saying, all right, let's do a quote, see what it'll look like. Right. Maybe they did have a negative experience with the new company or the new agency. While we love winbacks, they trusted us in the past. They trusted us in the past at some point in time to protect them. Right. They might have been with us for years and then they left and then we get them back. We start working our winbacks 5 months after they leave on auto, 5 months after they leave, around the time that they're getting their first renewal. Around the time they're getting the first renewal. So you need to have a process in place to work your winbacks, all right? Because winbacks are also free leads. You might have paid for it to begin with. See, they might have joined you because you bought an awesome live transfer from Quote Wizard. Your girl wrote it up, two cars and a home. Man, I hope an umbrella 4 years ago. But then they canceled, you know, in November. They left. They left. They went to another carrier, another company, whatever. I'm calling them now because guess what? Now's around the time they're going to be getting the renewal from me. You see what I'm saying? Have a process in place. And typically, y'all, when they come back, man, this GIF's annoying, isn't it? When they come back, they bring everything. That's why we love winbacks. But let's talk about your staff for a minute. What are some fears or concerns getting in their way? Maybe yours too. Maybe you're actively involved in quoting and prospecting and stuff as well. Similar to requotes, no analysis paralysis. Why'd they leave? Oh gosh, what happened? Who cares? A lot has changed. Was it our rates? A lot has changed, right? Did something bad happen? We don't know. A lot has changed. We don't know what's happened where they were, right? So what are the key words for winbacks? Just the same as requotes. A lot has changed. A lot has changed, right? And, you know, y'all, we teach all of this, you know, stuff on the platform. We actually do live trainings. What's really cool is when I'm doing the live trainings on Wednesday afternoons with everybody, it's all included in the membership. And I get people to volunteer, staff to volunteer from all across the country, sometimes owners, which I love. I love when owners step up to role play. It's just so powerful just to pull up the script, just to literally pull up the script. I teach it for a minute. I role play it with them as the agent first. They're the customer. And then they do it back to me. Typically not perfect. So I give them a few little tips, have them do it again. It's amazing to see how people are thriving and flourishing with our scripts. I have a girl in Tennessee, works with one of the agencies that I work with personally, one of the ones that I work with a couple times a month individually. And in like her second month, it was either the second or third month, did almost 50 policies in like her second month, I believe. Brand new insurance, just working winbacks and requotes. Winbacks and requotes is all she was working. Literally just reading our scripts and following our sales process. And she was still so new that people like having to help her close the deals. She was licensed, had binding authority and all that stuff. But she was doing so much activity, like the office manager and other team member producer was having to help her close out some deals. And she told me in the live training, so Joseph, I'm still learning this stuff. I'm just reading your scripts. I just want to tell you that they're working. This month, y'all, that was a couple months ago. This month, she's on track to write like 80 policies. She's been in insurance like 4 or 5 months. And yes, she's learned a lot now. She's learned a lot, but still a lot of room to grow. She's going to be an Next Century Club winner for sure. 100 plus in a month. But here's winbacks. Most common objections we get are, I don't have time right now, you know, or I'm not interested, or I didn't have a great experience, or your rates were too high. What are the key words? A lot has changed, right? Up here at the introduction, a lot has changed before we go into the assumptive quote. Do you still have the same types of cars? Are you still 123 Main Street, etc.? So that's winbacks. The last topic that I want to hit just for a few minutes, and then we're going to get to some questions, all right? And y'all, I hope that this is helpful. I hope that you're getting at least one or two nuggets that you can start utilizing immediately right away. The fact that I'm sharing all these scripts and resources, you can just screenshot them, use them. I'm trying to help you. If I'm missing something, or if you say, Joseph, I won't help with something else, shoot me an email, joseph@craigwigginscoaching.com. I'll pull that up again in just a minute, but I felt led to say that. I know I'm going really fast, but I'm just trying to cram as much as I can into this hour. All right, cross-selling and bundling. What option is easier? Picking up $1 bills at a time or carrying a wheelbarrow, carrying $20 bills, $50 bills, $100 bills. This is the analogy to use with your staff. For them to write 50, 60, 70, 80 policies a month, 100 policies a month, they don't have to make 50, 60, 70 sales. Maybe it's 20 or 30 sales to write 50 items a month. Yeah, maybe it is 30 or 40 sales to write 100 items a month. That's only one or two a day. One or two sales in a day in an 8-hour period, especially if that's their top priority is production and prospecting and all that stuff. Closing one sale a day, one household a day should be a minimum expectation, right? If they're bundling, it'll be way more than just 20 items though, or 20 policies. It'll be 40, 50, maybe even more. So that's why bundling and cross-selling is so important. Here are some good metrics that I would like for y'all to shoot for your agency as a whole, but also for your individual team members. You know, what I want to be shooting for is we got to protect the needs of our customers, y'all. At the end of the day, our job is not to save people money on their insurance. Our job is not just to give people service with a smile. You know, thank you, come again. Our job is to put ourselves in position to help our customers when they need us. How can we do that? How can we do that if we don't have their home insured, if we don't have their cars insured or their boat or motorcycle, if we've never even talked to them about an umbrella or life insurance? How can we truly protect our customers if we haven't sold them? See, service is sales. Sales is service. Okay. So these are kind of minimum metrics that I want your producers to be shooting for every month and your agency to be at overall. Auto and property, at least 8 out of 10 times. I'll give you one or two customers monoline, you know, just one type of policy. Maybe they don't qualify for the other line. Rarely they won't have a need for the other line because of a situation at home or whatever. Sometimes they qualify, but we're just way too far out. And we teach you and your staff in Craig Williams Coaching's On Demand program how to sell deals where you're higher every day. But at some point, it's not going to happen, right? We quote somebody $3,000 every 6 months because they have two or three young drivers and a couple tickets. Their insurance score is not so hot. And they're paying another, you know, direct carrier $1,400 every 6 months. We're probably not going to get that deal, right? So understand that. So I'll give you one or two customers out of 10 that are just one policy type, auto or property. 8 out of 10, though, auto and property. We must bundle. Now, 3 out of 10 customers, I'd love for that umbrella to be included. To do that, though, we quote it 10 out of 10 times. 100% of the time, we're bundling auto, property, umbrella in the package. That then gives us some wiggle room, some things that we can peel off or tweak at the end. Maybe we can table it at the end if necessary to get the deal. But y'all, if you're going to be higher, you might as well be worth it. You know, people aren't going to pay your team members more money for their policies just because you're nice, you know, because we're local, you know, we're accessible. You know, y'all, Geico is an amazing insurance company. Amazing. Their service, awesome. Claims, shoot. Forget about it, right? Some of us on the direct carrier side might say the opposite of our own customers, you know, support sometimes. I'm just being real. What matters is not that we're local, that we're nice, that you can call me, text me anytime, deal with one person every time. No, what matters is that we're going to actually protect you. We're going to give you the coverages that you deserve to protect your income, your assets, your home equity, your future, your family, right? If we're going to be higher though, we got to make it worth it. If we're just quoting them apples to apples and expecting them to pay more because we're nice and local and we support our local softball teams, who cares? What slide was on? Who cares? Nobody. Y'all, if you're going to be $50 more a month, $100 more a month, be worth it. Package the umbrella every time. But I'm only expecting you to close it or your staff to close it 3 out of 10 times. Life insurance, so important. Specialty items. If y'all do these in your agency, boats, motorcycles, RVs, golf carts, you know, business insurance, potentially y'all might do commercial as well. Let's go deep. Let's go deep in the household. And that's where we get our wheelbarrow from, our wheelbarrow analogy, right? To make more sales, you don't have to actually make more sales. Just get more from each individual customer interaction, if they're an existing customer or at new business, right? Bundle customers will retain much better. So your long-term ROI is your cross-selling at new business, whether it's from a lead from Quote Wizard or you're doing a requote win back or marketing, you know, other marketing, direct mail, et cetera. They're going to retain so much longer. So the average tenure is around 7 years for a captive relationship with a customer. But the more bundled it is, the longer they'll stay. So if you're writing monoline junk, it might stick a couple years. Auto and property, 5-7 years, okay. Auto, property, umbrella, life, shoot. They're going to be with you for decades. Decades. So it will help you dramatically grow your business as you're improving retention with better bundled households. Let's make it about your staff too. It's going to lead to increases in their income, right? Increases in their income. They got that wheelbarrow, right? They got that wheelbarrow. They don't have to make 50 sales a month to write 50 policies a month. Maybe it's only 20 sales, one sale a day. Cross-selling, crucial to get the return on investment of all leads, marketing resources. You're going to generate way more sales per interaction, and that's important. We're going to maximize every at-bat with our customers, right? Every at-bat. Guess what, y'all? You're going to strike out more than you hit. And your staff need to know that. They will strike out more than they hit. But if you play baseball and can only hit the ball 1 out of every 5 times, you're a millionaire. Right? And a 20 to 30% close rate is about right. on the agency perspective. So when we are there, though, we got to maximize that at bat, not just bunt. We need to swing for that home run every time. And we're going to win more. We're going to win more. I promise you, yes, we're going to get more no's than yeses. I jokingly ask this question all the time in my live trainings, at our live events, when I'm working with teams all across the country. Every no gets you closer to what? And people that don't know me or never heard this, they say, yes, every no gets you closer to a yes, Joseph. I'm like, nope, no, it doesn't. Every no gets you closer to another no, another no, another no, then a yes. Of course, it's getting you closer to a yes. Right. But I illustrate it that way to understand we're going to strike out more than we hit. But when we're up to that plate, we need to maximize every at bat, including with our existing customers and especially definitely a new business, which will help you increase your return on investment for your leads and marketing. And just remember, our job is not just to save people money on their insurance. Our job, our role is to meet all of our customers' needs and to put ourselves in position to help them when they need us. Service is sales. Sales is service. Here's some metrics for you. This is a screenshot of one of our producers at Craig's agency, Beth. These are numbers from 2021. All right. So this is last calendar year's numbers. 537 cars. See, 537 new cars. No, we don't count ad items. We don't count those. 365 homes. That's crazy. Like literally one for every day of the year. 287 umbrellas. Where is that? Here, personal umbrella policy, 287 umbrellas. Other, 411, renters, landlord boats, et cetera. She wrote 1,600 items, 1,600 policies. Y'all see that here in the year today? Oh, can y'all see my mouse moving? Maybe, I don't know. 1,600. The year before that was 1,672. So I actually got on to her. I was like, Beth, you wrote less in 2021 than you did 2020. I kind of got on to her. Jokingly, of course, we'll take this all day, every day. She's already on track this year to beat that. She averaged 133 policies a month and 133 policies in 2021. She's averaging like 145-ish, 150-ish this year. Been with us for about 8 years, following our scripts, our top paths, our resources. But y'all, the reason she wrote 1,600 was she didn't just write mainly autos or just write mainly homes. Hardly ever sprinkling an umbrella, not even talk to her customers about other things like motorcycles, boats, ATVs, etc. Y'all, bundle, she has a wheelbarrow. Okay. Do your staff's numbers look like this? I don't know. Maybe if so, that's good. Let's keep them going though. Let's keep them going. We can still make everybody a little bit better. Right. Here is, let's see, Beth's actual total book of business policies in force. 5,400 policies in force. 62% of one of our producers, customers has an umbrella, auto property and umbrella. That is an insane statistic. What does your book look like? Well, remember y'all, my goals, my minimum metrics would be this: 80% bundled, 30% including umbrella, 10% life/other. All right. So I'm just showing you real legit numbers. I mean, you can't make these up. Let's grow. Let's grow from our leads and marketing, from the internet leads and live transfers, from Quote Wizard. Let's grow from working win backs, requotes, cross sells. Let's grow by getting better at asking for referrals from our customers, at developing referral relationships, at other marketing resources, being involved in the community, all those things. Let's grow and let's work hard, but I also want us to work smart. I want us to work really, really smart. We're going to do that by bundling. Now, real quick, God, we're out of time. We got a few minutes for questions. You can take a screenshot. This is the cross-sell script that we use to start the mini review. Y'all, I don't want you or your team members to call your current customer and say, hey, it's me from your agency. Listen, can I sell you something real quick? See, that's what your customers or prospects hear. When you or your team members call and say, hi, it's so-and-so from your agency. Listen, I was giving you a call because you're missing our multiple policy discount. Can we give you a competitive quote on your home or your auto insurance? No, thanks. I'm good. No, we don't teach to do that. We teach to lead with a mini review of their current insurance. And here's the script that we do that. We thank them for how long they've been with us. Let them know that we took a look at their policy and found a few things we just need to go over to them real quick. It's important. It won't take a few minutes. Let me start with this coverage. We assume the mini review and don't say things like, hey, is this a good time? Mm-hmm. They got a minute, y'all. They answer the phone. They got a minute. Never, ever allow your staff to say, hey, is this a good time? Or would you like a review? Who here wants to review on their insurance today? Y'all, I hate the dentist. Hate the dentist. I'm sorry. I just don't go. I don't like it. I mean, I go only because they made me. They guilted me last time, so I waited a few years. Well, that made me feel really bad. So anyways, I hate the dentist, but I go, y'all, I'd rather go to the dentist than have an insurance review. So see, by teaching your staff the right questions to ask, they're going to get fewer and fewer objections. Don't ask if this is a good time or if you want a review. Just assume the review and go into it, right? Here's some common objections, et cetera. Again, don't have time to teach this. Y'all, I'm at the end. I see we've got a couple questions. We only have like 4 or 5 minutes, though. Last slide. If we can help you and your team, I would highly encourage that you take advantage through Friday, 5 o'clock Eastern Friday, use QW2022, a little promo code at craigwiggins.com/on-demand. Try us out for $20, $20.22. If you hate it, you don't think it's for you, cancel it. Or you could be like one of the almost 1600 agencies and 9,000 people in our program. They get so much value from it. It's the best $6 a day they invest in their team. Think about how much money and leads and marketing that you're spending. Hundreds of dollars a month, thousands of dollars a month. Some of y'all might be exceeding 5 figures a month. Let's make sure your staff are prepared to work all these leads and to bundle well and to write a ton of business so that you can crush your goals. But with that said, my girl Kelsey came back on. We got like 3 or 4 minutes. Got some questions here, Kelsey. Do you have anything that you want to go over before I maybe answer a couple of these questions?
Not personally. I thought all of that was amazing. It's funny, like I learn a lot from you guys too, even though we don't earn or own an agency. A lot of it can be applied to other, you know, sales companies. But yeah, let's just try and quickly go through some of this stuff. We have an agent asking, you know, what if you have a customer that's been with you for many years and they've been kind of disgruntled by the price, they ultimately leave. And then all of a sudden your carrier cuts prices in half. And so you're trying to win them back. How do you have that conversation with and convince them that you weren't just like inflating their price all those years?
Sure. So that will be a win back, right? A win back. You know what, Kelsey? I have amazing news. Amazing news. I'm so glad that I caught you because you know what? I took a look at those policies that you used to have with us. I'm excited to let you know, Kelsey, a lot has changed. Where is he? A lot has changed. And we're going to be able to help you again. So I'm so glad that I caught you. Real quick, you guys still at 123 Main Street? Assume the quote. A lot has changed. What if they say, your rates are too high? You know what? You're going to be impressed. A lot's changed, Kelsey. We miss you. We miss you. Almost at Allstate. Our company, our carrier, is putting together some great rates for you. I've already taken liberty to see what we could do. You're going to want to talk for a minute. So different cars or same cars? Get back to the assumptive quote. Sometimes people might be like, why didn't you just, you know, charge me less to begin with? Okay, fine, right? That's going to come up. Hey, things change. You know, our company is constantly trying to figure out the best ways that we can, you know, welcome new families in our agency and we want to price things well. I think they realized that we could have done better for you. So now we're going to fix that. We're going to fix that right now. We're going to do better today. So real quick, what types of cars you got? All right, get back into the assumptive quote. Stacy, yeah, were you going to go with Stacy about wanting to do the ROI, the math of it all? That's a great question, Stacy. I've got my little slide here on like the cost of leads and stuff. I didn't put together a formula because y'all, there's so much to take into account. You got the cost of the leads. Let's say you spend $3,000 a month on life transfers with Kelsey, right? And they'll be worth every penny, right? $3,000 for 50 live transfers. I'm just making up numbers, $60 a lead, whatever. I'm just making up numbers. Well, you get 60 leads. Your team quotes 40 of them and you write 8 of them. Well, let's say you wrote 8 of those 60 customers in the first month. How many policies? If you're our agency, your policy count is going to look like Beth's numbers. Shoot, where is it? I got too many slides, y'all. Yo, your policy is going to look like whatever, wherever it is, right? Like this. See, her cost of acquisition is dramatically lower than the cost of acquisition if we had just wrote that prospect's 2 cars. So it's really hard to put math into it. The cost of acquisition, though, there's lots of different ways that y'all can look at it. Lots of different ways that y'all can look at, you know, doing the math. What I would just challenge you is understand that there should be a long-term focus. not just expecting to make a profit today, but with a 7-year average tenure, if you're making money with renewals within 6 to 18 months, if you have that positive ROI within 6 to 18 months, you know, 6 months to a year and a half, I would tell you call Kelsey and buy as many of those as you can. That's an amazing deal considering that the average tenure is just over 7 years. All right. Eric says, what's your suggestion when someone is angry and hangs up on you? Next. Seriously, dude, I love it. I love no. And I teach that to our staff, right? Let's get excited for no. Embrace no. Someone cusses at you, hangs up. Good. Next. You know, I'd rather do it. See, Kelsey, you're a sweet girl, aren't you? You're a sweet, nice woman. Are you nice? Like, you're super nice. Let me ask you something, Kelsey. You ever hung up on a telemarketer before?
No.
No, don't you lie to me.
No, I promise. Because I was in sales. Maybe if I wasn't in sales, I'd hang up.
let me flip it back to me then. Kelsey, I'm a married, happily married man of 17 years, whatever. I got 3 kids, very successful businesses, well-loved in the community. I'm a good guy. Good guy, I think, I hope, I pray. You think I've ever hung up on a telemarketer before? Heck yeah, dude. I'm not interested in a car warranty or whatever. Now, if they used a better script, I might not. But honestly, I see it as doing them a favor. I try politely to say, no, thank you, not interested. They keep going, ba-da-da-ba-da-ba, hang up. I'm doing them a favor, y'all. Y'all, they did you a favor. I'd rather someone say, never call me again. I'm not interested. Bleh. Me hateful about it. Good. You know what? That's better than just ignoring your calls and you and your staff leaving voicemail after voicemail after voicemail. Good. Next. Some will. Some won't. So what? Next. That type of mentality. So I love it when someone hangs up. Next. All right.
We did have a couple questions. If you have just a couple more minutes.
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good. Yeah.
Okay, cool. So Samantha would like to know how you get into the conversation of an umbrella. Like if you're just trying to convince your average Joe that it's worth their money. Yes. Like, what do you say?
So, all right, hold on. So in our last training, was that in January when I did that webinar? Was it January or February? I did a webinar with y'all and I actually went over this in depth. So maybe you can find that on the Quote Wizard blog. But real quick, here's CWC scripts in PDF format, page 17. We don't have time to dive deep into this. Nope, that's something close. Page 16, Lead with Liability Top Path. I know this font might seem kind of small, I'm trying to make it a little bit bigger. But anyways, we ask these questions in this order. What are your current liability limits? If they don't know, we tell them. Do you understand what those coverages mean? Not asked in a condescending way or anything, but just gauging the level of understanding. How much do you carry on your umbrella? What is your umbrella policy limit? Most people be like, what are you talking about with this? I've never heard of no umbrella, right? That most have never heard of it. That's when we change our tone. When was the last time your agent discussed your coverages with you? I'm shocked and concerned that they've put you in this position. Based on what you discussed, these limits are too low and I don't understand why they gave them to you. Let me explain. I want to tell you about what happened to one of our customers. We tell a story, we make them do the math. We don't have time to do this, but y'all, the average Joe, you don't got to be a millionaire to be sued like one. Y'all, the people that can't afford the right coverages, now they got the new iPhone. They got the new Apple Watch 7. Why'd I get a 7? I had a 5. It's literally basically the same thing, right? They got the Jordans, okay? Right? The people that can't afford the right coverages, y'all, they're the ones that need it. People, you know, that if 20% of their wages were garnished, or if they owned a home and a lien was placed on their home, if they were having to spend $400 or $500 an hour for an attorney just to look at their case, but they couldn't afford that, those are the ones that need to go an extra $50 to $100 a month to have the right coverage, right? So anyways, I would encourage you to check out the webinar I did a couple months ago. It's awesome. And if you join the program with CWC, you're going to learn so much more than that. All right. What else, Kelsey? Anything else before we let everyone go?
Yes. So Jeremy would like to know what channels produce the highest percentage of contacts and quotes, like texting versus phone versus email. And then he also wants to know, kind of lumped in with that question, is what percentage of leads will typically result in a quote like over a longer span? Like, is 50% after 6 months a good or bad number?
So a couple things. All the methods of communication, like if I scroll up to my seeds, where's my seeds, right? Here I got my seeds, right? Every voicemail, every email, every handwritten card, every compliantly sent text message. I don't know what company you're with, but some companies are super strict on how you can text, even call. Y'all, TCPA compliance, you do not want to mess with. You do not want to mess with compliance. You don't want to get sued, you know, because you're doing, you know, bad things. But anyways, I love texting. So if I go back, you know, to the calls and emails, the reason I didn't put texting in here, because y'all, you have got to be compliant with texting and phone calls and stuff like that. But long story short, people will text you all damn day. They won't pick up the phone for a 5-minute phone call, but they'll text you for an hour. Fine. Let's communicate with our customers in the manner in which they want to be communicated. Maybe it's texting. I'm an emailer. I love email. I do everything, like my personal business stuff, email. You call me, you're not going to get me. I'm on trainings all day, right? I love email. I'm okay with texting, but I really prefer emails. So it's just easier for me to manage and organize. So anyways, long-term, you know, 50% of the time, you know, what lead source will close 50% of the time, that would be, you know, cross-selling existing customers, referrals. We'll likely close at a higher rate than that. Will you ever close 50% of the internet leads that you buy today? Probably not. Right, even over like a 5-year period, but should it be 20 to 30% over 6 to 12 months or so? Yes. Just remember, persistence pays. It's going to take 20 plus actions from any of these sales, right, y'all? But y'all, we love win backs, requotes, cross sales. That's why I spent so much time talking about them today, mainly because they're free, right? Even if we pay for them to begin with, they're free. But I can't stress enough the importance of working with our friends at Quote Wizard. Y'all, we got to keep fresh stuff coming in. We got to keep fresh stuff coming in from new internet leads to new live transfers. We can't just rely on working the old stuff over and over and over again, but make sure you're working the old stuff, y'all. Old leads are gold leads. Don't give up on them. Don't just constantly be staring at the Glengarry leads right in front of you and just focusing on those. Let's go back through the people we quoted 6 months ago, 2 years ago, people that we lost 3 years ago, 5 years ago. Let's make sure that as we're working with customers, that we're going deeper and doing reviews and finding cross-sell opportunities. Watch your numbers go through the roof and your overall return on investment for all of your leads and marketing be insanely better. All right. Is there anything else or are we good? I know we went a tad over, but that's okay.
Well, there is one final question. Okay. What your opinion is on using telemarketers versus team members to cold call leads?
So for us, we're a big fan of our team members making the calls. You know, we don't have separate telemarketers. Now, some agencies do, but our team members, let me go back to my pyramid. Where's my pyramid? Our team members, Beth Lambrecht, you know, Josephine Jones, our agents, they're the ones making 80 to 120 plus calls a day. They then immediately do the quote. They then immediately write the business. You know, if you wanted to hire a young person that maybe wanted to get their toes, you know, in the door in insurance, I'm okay with that. But what I love is when they do the calls, they generate the quotes, they take it. It's like having the one quarterback take them through the whole process, not, hey, would you want to talk about your insurance? Okay, well, not with me, because I don't know what the hell I'm doing. Let me send you somebody else. I just don't like that feel. Now, I get why Quote Wizard does that, you know, because they have telemarketers that generate leads and pass them to y'all. That's great. That's great. Internally, though, our agents are the telemarketers. Beth Lambert, you know, the girl I showed y'all her numbers. Where's her numbers at? You know, I showed her numbers. She averages probably 120 calls a day. And writes 2 to 3 customers a day. That's how she wrote her item, 1,600 items, 133 policies a month. That's 2 to 3 sales a day. 2 to 3 sales a day, y'all. That's like one sale every 3 hours. That's extremely reasonable. If y'all look at these numbers and think this is impossible, you're correct. You're right. It is impossible for you. It is impossible for your staff. Y'all, I can promise you one thing. I am never going to run a mile in under 5 minutes. Y'all, I probably couldn't run a mile in under 15 minutes, okay? But I will never run a mile in under 5 minutes. Y'all, in the history of mankind, no one had ever broke a 5-minute mile until someone actually did. Then within the next month, hundreds of people all around the world did, because all of a sudden it became possible. So you think it's impossible? Correct. You're right. What we do is we think bigger. We think bigger and we get more from our staff. And I hope that you guys have all gotten just a few nuggets from today watching this call to do the same. Kelsey, I appreciate you. Quote Wizard, thank you for inviting me. Everyone that watched live, everyone watching the recording now, thank you for your time. If I helped you with just one little thing today, man, it'll be worth it. It'll be worth it. So I appreciate it. Kelsey, any final thoughts from you before we let everybody get back to work?
No, but thank you so much for being here. Obviously, guys, I said this last time. It's very clear that Joseph has so much more to say. He's just restricted to the time limit I've given him. So I cannot stress enough. I highly recommend checking out CWC. They have so many resources. There's so much more to even the topic we covered today. So that's definitely great. Check them out. I will be following up with an email with the recording, like I said, and I'll include all of the promotional details as well if you do want to take advantage of that discounted price for your first month. So definitely recommend it. But thank you so much again, Joseph. I'm sure we'll see you again very soon.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you all. Now, everybody, let's get back to work. We got policies to write and people to protect. Let's go. Have a great rest of the day.
Bye, everyone.